Hello friends, how are you doing? Memo here, Memo33 here. I'm checking the new cards in the new expansion, and Secret Mage is going to be the nuts. Overpowered, broken. No. Secret Mage in Wild, they're going to nerf at last Secret Mages in Wild. First of all, I'm going to use my best English. I'm going to give you some recommendations to use RNG cards. What is RNG? It means random number generators. Hearthstone right now has a lot of RNG. Even Creeparian say that the RNG is destroying the game because it doesn't matter if you play with skill. If opponent is more luckier than you, you will lose. So never take this game seriously. Imagine that you are playing chess and suddenly the queen jumps and checkmates the king and you won because you were lucky. So there's no thinking, it was only luck. So this game has not a lot of skill. It's just be lucky and play your best. So I'm going to give you some theory on what cards you can add to your decks so you can win a lot. I'm going to make this video as fast as possible and get to the points. There are a lot of cards that depend a lot in luck because they have a range like from 1 to 10. And one of these cards that I don't like because the RNG is extremely high is this, Snitz. Okay, the problem with Snitz is that the range is from 1 to 10. It's almost a random legendary. So the bad part about this is that you can summon Apaches, a very, very lame card. You can summon this minion, Shifter Zerus, or even Patches. These two cards, you can even this chamaleos, you can get those cards with Snitz. So that is a possibility, and that's why that card is not good, because you will have a very low win rate. You have to understand that there's a lot of ways to abuse RNG, to be like a cheater, to abuse this mechanic. There's a card of Hunter that was, because the card was so broken, using it in that deck, okay? There is a spell, there is this card. This card was before Draw a Beast, give +3/+3. So you can simply add 4 beasts, only 4 beasts or 5. That card combos a lot with this card because it's a copy of this. So if this has 4/4, you will have 2 4/4s for 1. This card is ultra power creep of Alicat because it's the same fucking card, but this summons a 1/1 cat and this a copy. It's much better card. It's a same card, but this is a 1/1 and this is a copy for the same class, and it costs the same and it has the same stats. Power creep in this game is stupid. Just delete this fucking card, delete it from the game. There's another card that has a lot of RNG and never use that card. Is this card Baron's Stemminghand. Battlecry, summon a random beast. Okay, the problem with this card is that you can get, you already know, a very weak beast, a boar. You can get a boar or Alicat with this minion. You pay 7 for 4/4 that summons a Alicat because Alicat is a beast. The problem with these cards is that random is a range from 1 to 10. You can get a King Crush or you can get an Alicat. That's why you must never use these cards. These cards are trash because of the range. You have to use RNG cards when where you can control the effects, like the combo I already said. And there's a lot of cards that have very good RNG, that have more control RNG, and those cards, look at this card, okay? This card says summons a random 4 costs minion. That's okay. That's very nice because it's a 4 costs. It's not bad, but this shit is a random. It can be anything. This card, for it to work, must say a summon a random 6 or 7 cost beasts to above to be able to not to summon weak beasts, because paying 7 to have a 4/4 that. So this way you can exploit the game. You can make a lot of combos, like Baroness from Big Priests. With Baroness you can summon this card, or you can summon Ragnaros, or really really strong cards, because in Big Priest the only strong minions you have were very strong minions, and RNG works at your favor, because if you don't have weak cards you can get a lot of minions very powerful, then revive them with priests in wild. So that's a very nice way to manipulate and to abuse RNG. Another card that I think is very good, that has good RNG, is this card. Why? Because by paying 10 you can get another puzzle box, or you can get a pyroblast, or you can activate secrets. This card is very good because it's a last resource card. This card is a good RNG, because you can get like 10 pyroblasts to the face, you can get power of creation, you can get this, you can get a lot of cards. So this is a very good RNG card. Okay, this is are some random cards. This card is also very bad card. I play it when I was a noob, but the problem is that you must have a beast on your board, and it's random. This card is garbage because you can get an ally cat. This card, we have a lot of range right now. We have a lot of possibilities in RNG. We need this card to summon a cost. If you have a beast, summon a 5 to above random beast, that's good. But they have to buff these cards, because if they don't buff these cards, they are dead. They are useless. So you have to. Also, this card is good, but the problem is that you can summon Apaches. This, you can summon Apaches with this, and you paid 7, and you summon Apaches. These cards must be buff. They need to change the effects. This card must summon a random 5 to above cost legendary minion, or 6, but not random because of the range. A lot of cards have very high costs and low income, like this card. This card costs a lot. 6 is a lot just to destroy a random minion, and for each player. So this card can kill itself, and you have to tap and draw one card, and it costs 6. This card is garbage because it costs a lot and it does almost nothing. It can kill your own minions, and it costs a lot. For this card to be usable, you have to make it cost 4. If this card costs 4, maybe it will have more playability, but 6 for that effect sucks. No thank you. All these cards that gives you random paladin cards, they are terrible because the range is very high. At a random, you can get a secret, a useless secret for paying 6. Not, doesn't worth it. This card also sucks because you have to drop it in your turn 7 and use hero power to get a random spell. It can be arcane missiles for 7 mana. It doesn't worth it. It sucks. They really have to change these cards for them to be viable, to be good. This card is nice. Very nice, because you can get you have a larger range of legendaries. if you have a card like Snitz that only summons one legendary minion, it sucks because you are paying 8 for Apaches. But this card, you pay 6 and you can get your 1/1 tokens, have like Mal'Ganis and Deathwing, so this card is very nice. There's RNG controls RNG like this card, because if you have your opponent with a minion with exactly 5 life, this will kill it if it's not a mech. So that is good control RNG. This card is a very fun card in Secret Mesh, because you can use Mad Scientists and activate this from your deck, and maybe you can get the Shaman 477 without Overlords in your first turn if you use the 2/1 Cabal that activates a secret from your hand when you play it. Many people say, no, this card sucks because you play 3 mana and you get a 4 cost minion at random. Okay, I know, that sucks, but what if you activate this card with Mad Scientists or with a Cabal that activates from your when you drop? Evocation is a card that has super RNG, but there's Sorcerer's Apprentice that is going to be nerfed maybe in Hall of the Fame, but this card is nice. I like this card because you can get a lot of cheap spells with Apprentice and make a lot of mayhem. This card is good RNG. Another card with good RNG is this card, because it's always very nice in Evo Shaman, because doesn't matter what minions cost one more, because this card is so powerful, because you can trade your minions, and if they are about to die, you just attack with this and they fully heal and transform even better to have stronger minions. This card is RNG, but it's controls, so it's very good card. There's other cards that have RNG like this. This card is RNG. It deals 3 damage to one random minion of your friendly minion, but if you don't have minions, then this spell makes 3 damage for one. That's good. You are abusing it because you are not destroying your own minions, only opponents. You don't have any drawback, so it's a good RNG card, so that you are not going to play anything before using this card. You are not stupid. There's other RNG cards like this, Hellbord. I think this card, if you are using some Death Rattle beasts, don't use this card. This card is so bad because you're losing hands, okay? Doesn't matter how strong your minions drop, they're going to get transformed or destroyed, so the buffs of beasts are not good. I have played a lot of these decks, they're Rattle Hunters, and they lose very fast, because the problem with Hunter is that it doesn't have strong card power, draw power. It doesn't have good draw power, so you will lose a lot of hand, and you will lose the game because you don't have any way to recover the cards you draw. This card is one of the worst cards with RNG. Replace your hand with random demons, okay? You can get pure shit with this card. If you have Twister Nettles, if you have Hellfire, you have Mal'Ganis, say goodbye to those cards and you will have random stupid demons. You can have the 0/1 that gives one life, or Fire Demon, or very weak demons. This card is only good when you are playing in some adventure, okay? But never ever I have seen people that use this card. Don't use this card. This card is garbage because it destroys your strategy, because you don't know what are you going to get. You can get a handful of Mal'Ganis and you are in turn one. You cannot play them. So this card is garbage. The problem with Blizzard is that Blizzard thinks that RNG is fun, but it's not fun. This is not fun. This is stupid. You have to make RNG cards with more control effects. This is not controllable. You cannot return scans to your... This is another RNG card, but this card is garbage because you can drop any demon from your hand. You can drop a very weak demon. I think that these cards will be good if you can select the demon you're going to summon. You can select it, but no, it's total RNG. It's a casino, it's gamble. No, this is stupid, because Demon Hunter, his demons suck. Okay, that's why almost no one uses demons, only Warlock, because Warlock has one of the best demons in the game. Demon Hunter, no. So this card should be for Warlock, not for Demon Hunter. And that's a problem with this game, is that we have a lot of RNG cards that don't have a punch like this. This card is a Satanic 666, and you got a random demon. It can be any demon. No, that doesn't, that is not good. This is another RNG card. You have to hit face with this card. This card will be good if it had charge. If this card had charge, it's a very nice card, but no. If opponents drop this minion, this card will be destroyed in the next turn. Opponent will not take the risk for this. There's a lot of removal in this game, so all these cards are garbage. The effects are too weak, so that makes players use the best cards in the game. That means that there's almost no variety and no skill involved in deck building, because why the hell will I use these cards if I can have a more secure deck? When I was a noob, I used this card. I was such a noob. You get a random card from your hand, card to your hand from your opponent class. That's garbage because of the range. If you are busy as a paladin, you can get a secret, a very useless secret, and this card is so weak. It's going to die like this, because opponents hates leaving this kind of cards, because they don't like to be in jeopardy. So this card will die instantly. But the problem is that it's random, so it's stupid. This card is good because if opponent drops a Doomsayer, you can drop this card as a counter and destroy his Antonidas to stop Exodia OTK Mage. But there are cards that are very good like this. This card is one of the best priest cards right now, because it has a lot of health and you can revive it 1, 2, and 3 times over and over again, and it can keep destroying enemy minion. This card is super strong. This card must be nerfed to cost 4 life or cost 6. This card has RNG, but the problem is the situation. Okay, imagine that opponent has a lot of minions and you draw this card. It's useless. That's the problem with this game, that if you add this card and you don't get it in your first turns, it will be totally useless in the future. That's the problem. If you could get these cards from the start, like draw this card in your first turns, then it will be very good. But you have a range of 30 cards in your deck, and if you don't get this card in your starting turns, then this card is garbage. You will not. And I think that's it. I just want to mention you guys that every card with RNG is not bad, but you have to consider that you almost always have to abuse the card, because this card was useless, but it was very good when with the spells, the cheap spells, and with Overgrowth. Now this card is good, and it is RNG, but the good thing is that you can abuse the spells and make a lot of any card can be good. Any card can be good. The problem is the new cards, the meta, the combinations of the new cards, because this card was useless, as I said, and it got very good with the cheap spells of Druid. My advice in here is to get almost every card in the game. Get all the cards in the game, so you'll be able to have a lot of possibilities to make your own deck. and I think that's it. You always use the best cards, don't use the bad cards, don't use cards that its RNG is from 1 to 10. No, you have to have control effects, okay? Like this. I used this card when I was young and I deal 2 damage and summon a random demon. You can get this or a very weak minion, an useless minion, because a range is very, very big. You can get something really bad and you're paying 5. That's the problem. This card is one of the most broken cards in the game because you can drop a Mal'Ganis or a Void Lord or a lot of strong minions because this effect is controllable. So it's a good card. This card is garbage because doesn't matter if the card costs 1 less, you return minions to your hand. You are losing tempo. O sea, no, this card is bad. You have to understand that all these old cards, these cards came from a lot of time. I think this is from Naxxramas, let's see. Yep, of Naxxramas, long time ago. So this card was good at this time. Okay, it was good when it came out, but right now you cannot go back. That's the problem with this game. Hearthstone is all about advancing. Okay, you cannot go back in Hearthstone. You cannot. It's very hard. If you try to make a priest deck, you cannot use Dark Cultist because its time is over. Okay, the card is not good because there are better cards. I have seen a lot of people that play this card and like, why? This card is no. O sea, maybe it's good, maybe it's not, but you must advance. Each time you have to have the best decks in the meta for you to able to win. This card has RNG, but it does nothing and it's a random shaman spell. You can get something really bad. I have seen people play this card and I laugh like it. Really, this card is useless because it has random. Don't use this kind of cards. This card is random, but you can control it. What happens if you have only the spider? Legendary cost 9 breed that revives all the towns. You can revive it and then use the cube or use naturalizing it. These RNG cards, you can abuse them by having only the minion you need. Don't be open for a lot of possibilities. We have a small possibility. This card is garbage. I use this card in Odd Paladin to trade my Silver Knights. What was I thinking? If you want to win in this game, you must use the best, strongest decks. Don't fuck around in this game, okay? Don't try to have fun. Yes, I want to have fun. No. The more fun you want to have, the more possibilities you have to lose. That's reality. I have played with a lot of fun decks made by me, homebrews, yes, I'm going to use this with Odd Paladin because it costs 3, and I lose because opponent is not cheating around. He wants to kick your ass. Okay, if you want to win in this game, you have to like get the best decks, the most strongest decks in the game, and have your RNG very specified and very concrete. If not, you're going to lose. And I think that's it. You have to understand that that's it. That's everything I have to say. Just be smart with your RNG effects. Always check the range. If you have 1 to 10, like random beasts, random this, you have to know all the cards in the game. Okay, if you know that there's a lot of weak beasts, like I don't know, this card summons a random legendary and you know that there's a weak legendary, don't use that because you can get that legendary. Those cards were good in the past because let's say that you summon a legendary, a beast, but in that time in the game there were no low costs beasts, legendary minions. Okay, so you can get a 5 to a buff because it was in the card pool, but right now no, there's a lot of range, so those cards are crap. So I'm going to make a video reviewing all these new cards in the last stream in next weekend with Creep. I think Creeprian will be analyzing the cards, and we will see. And this card is RNG. It discovers a secret. Discover is RNG, but you have three choices. With the other cards, it was totally random. Okay, RNG is good if you have discovered, add to it. This card will be super powerful in secret spell hunter. Very strong. Because the secret you discover will be random, but you have three choices. It's not like random. And you cast it. Wow. Very, very good card. I'm going to use that card. So that's it. Please do what I say, what I recommend. Don't use RNG cards that have a lot of range. Use more focus RNG, more controlled RNG, and learn all the cards in the game so you know that you can have a possibility to summon that card. So don't use that. Okay, thank you, bye bye, take care, bye.